Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you Cyclic Redundancy Check CRC for error detection. CRC is broadly used in computer network for error detection. You should know there are two methods which is widely used for error detection. One is CRC and second is checksum. In my previous video, I have explained you what is checksum and how to solve checksum, right? Here I'll be explaining you CRC. What I'll do is I'll solve two problems based on CRC over here, and I can give you guarantee based on those two problems you can solve any questions based on CRC. You can observe, by just spending 10 minutes you can be able to solve any question based on CRC. So let me tell you first how many basics are there with CRC. Cyclic redundancy check, that we use it for error detection, and here in CRC, we will be using divisor. So divisor will be given to you, and length of the divisor, that is L bits. Divisor may be given in terms of Galois field. So if it is given in terms of Galois field, it will be looking like some polynomial will be given. Like you see here in problem, I'll be giving you divisor in terms of Galois field. So I'll show you like how to convert that in terms of bits. The reason is here every calculation that I'm going to explain you in terms of binary, I'll not explain you things in terms of Galois field. The reason is it is a bit tricky to explain you. So here we will be performing binary division for CRC generation, and you should know receiver and transmitter both should be agreed upon same divisor. So transmitter and receiver both should be having same divisor, then only receiver can detect error. So first of all, you need to understand how transmitter is generating code word. So for that, let me give you one practical example. So here you see data that is given and divisor is also given. We are dealing with to find code word generated by transmitter. So here, first of all, what you need to do is you will have to write this data. So let me write it 01010001. After writing this data, you will have to see how much redundancy that we need to add. So based on divisor, we need to identify that additional bits. So you see, in total we are having 4 bits with divisor. So here L minus 1 number of bits that I need to append over here. So L minus 1 means 3 bits. So 0, 0, 0. As divisor is having 4 bits, I need to append 3 bits over here. Now, few precautions that you need to take care. So that's why I just request you to draw line over here. Why? The reason is when you do division, then you will have to do division till all the zeros are there over this side, right? And this division that is happening as per Galois field, and in this division we are not interested about quotient. We are not interested about quotient. So I'm not going to write quotient value over here. I'll just do division only, right? And we are dealing with to find remainder only. So we will find remainder only. We will not focus on quotient. Now, how to do division? So see this divisor, that is 1001. So let us divide it over here. So 1001. So here, what will happen? You see here in Galois field, we just need to XOR this, right? You don't need to take carry over here. Like 01 XORing is 1 1 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 0. See, XORing, that we need to do. We don't need to take carry. You just need to do XOR operation, right? So this subtraction is just XORing. Here you don't need to take carry and then calculate further things like this, right? So just take care of this. So here we are having 0 0 1 1. Now again we are having 0 0. So just take 0 0 here. Again further do division. So 1 0 0 1. So for that, you see 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0. Then see, take this 1 over here. Again do further division. So 1 0 0 1. Here 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0. So still we are having some value over this side. So just take this 2 zeros over here and do this division as per divisor. So 1 0 0 1. So you see what is happening here. 1 1 0 0 0 0 000 and 011. And let us take this last 0 over here. So if you observe last 3 bits, that is 010. So that is my CRC. That is my CRC. So once you have CRC, what transmitter will be sending? Transmitter will be sending code word. So what is that code word? Code word will be this data. So that is 01010001. And along with that, it will send CRC. So it will send this CRC 010. So you should know this. Transmitter code word is what? It is a combination of data and CRC. So this is what transmitter will send over here. And receiver may receive errored data. And as if errored data that has been received by receiver, then also at receiver side, you can do same calculation and you will be getting whether error is there or not. Right. But right now, let us try to understand first how code word can be generated. So for that, let me give you one more example over here. So again, same practice that we will do. So let me write data first. I'm writing data 111001010 and 1 again. And you see here we are having divisor. So as we are having divisor, I need to write that divisor in form of binary data. So you see how to write this in binary form. So here x to the power 3 is there, means I need to write 1. After x to the power 3, x to the power 2 is there. So after 3, 2 is also having power, so I need to write 1. After x to the power 2, x to the power 1 is not available, so I need to write 0. X to the power 1 is not available, that's why I'm writing 0. And after that, x to the power 0, that is 1. So 1 is available, so I need to write 1 over here. So this is my divisor. So based on polynomial, I can write this divisor in form of binary data. Right. Now if you see how many bits are there with this divisor, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I need to append how many redundancy? 3 bits. So I'm writing 0, 0, 0. That is my redundancy. Right. And do not forget to draw line over here. The reason is I have seen students are making mistake in calculation as they are not drawing a straight line over here. Sometimes data may be like some confusing data may be there, and because of small errors, you may have false answer. So just do some proper practice as I am explaining it over here. Now let us do division. So 1101. So 1101 that I am dividing over here. So 110 110 101 1011. Again take these 2 bits and again do same thing, 1101. So 1101. So this will be 0, this will be 0, 0, and again 0. So up to this we have 0. Now we need to have further calculation. So I'm taking this 0, then 101. So let me write 101, but still we need to have 4 bits. So I'm taking 0 from here. Now 1101, that division that I'm doing. So 110 011 101 101. Now again I need to take this second 0 over here for further division. See, once you have all zeros over this side, then you will have to stop and you can take CRC, right? So 1101 that I need to divide over here. So you see now what is happening, 110 110 then 101 011. So now we are having all zeros over this side. So I can take this third digit over here, that is 0. So you can say this is our CRC, that is 110. So here transmitter code word, transmission code word, that is data plus CRC. So data is 111 00 10 101, that is my data, and CRC is 110. So this is my data and this is my CRC, right? And in total you can say this is my code word. So that is how simply we can generate code word. Now when receiver receives this, at that time there may be error. So how to identify error, that I'm going to explain you in next video. by one practical example, so that will give you more clarity. I hope CRC calculation is clear to you. Still, if anything that you'd like to share it with me, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.